category of one of those that has some other ideas as well. But I think that while the iron is hot and we do have a surgical and strategic proposal before us, we should act because immediate action can make a large difference in when the infusion comes back into the economy, when the tax breaks can be taken advantage of by business in terms of depreciation and expensing. And in particular for the housing market, the increased loan limits for Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, and FHA will be essential in saving some houses now in foreclosure from ultimate foreclosure because they'll be purchased by people with who qualify under the new loan limits and will be able to take that home and put it back as a performing asset. But it's to that subject that I want to talk for just a second, Mr. President. You know, experience is a great teacher. You know, there's an old saying, if a cat sits on a hot stove, they'll never sit on a hot stove again. Of course, they never sit on a cold stove either. They just get out of the business sitting on stoves. Well, in my business as a private sector businessman for years, I was in the real estate business in the 1970s. In particular, in the period of time between 1968, as a matter of fact, and 1999. In the mid-1970s, the United States of America faced a housing crisis almost identical to what's about to happen in this country today. In 1973 and 74, we had a huge housing boom, increasing values, credit got easier, loan limits got higher, and underwriting got lower. And what ended up happening is a lot of bad loans were made. In that particular period of time, many of them were to home builders rather than homeowners, but suffice it to say, it was the same underwriting problem, the same deficiency in terms of lending. A plethora of foreclosures took place. New homes went back, and the United States of America found itself in 1975 in a recession with a three-year supply of single-family houses on the market, unsold, and no housing market. The President of the United States and the Congress of the United States took action. They passed a $6,000 tax credit where you could collect $2,000 a year for 3 years to any family that purchased any standing new home in inventory and occupied it during those 3 years. Within the course of a year, we had reduced as a country a three-year supply of housing to a one-year supply of housing. We had reinvigorated the construction trade, the subcontractors, the building suppliers, those that manufactured carpet, washing machines, dryers, all the components that are so important in the overall economy that are spurred by home purchase. So I introduced a law along with Senator Gregg, Senator Craig, Senator Allard, and Senator Chambliss, Senate Resolution 2566, calling for us to repeat history in this country, to re-energize the housing market that's so sluggish, and at a strategic time where we can save houses pending foreclosure from actually being foreclosed on, turn them into owner-occupied single-family dwellings. Very simply, 2566 would do the tax credit, $5,000 a year for 3 years to any individual, couple, or two people living together filing separately, a $15,000 tax credit if they purchased and occupied as their home any single family dwelling on the market that was a new home permitted for construction before September 1st of last year and vacant, B, a home that has been foreclosed on, that was owner occupied and is now in REO, real estate owned category of any lender or bank or financial institution, and third, any property pending foreclosure that is owner-occupied. Mr. President, we all know from reading the paper that foreclosures are going up in geometric proportions. What's about to happen in the first quarter of this year is the largest realm of foreclosures that have taken place in this country in years, and what's going to go in the second quarter of this year is those banks being told by regulators that they have to get rid of that inventory, they can't keep it on their books. And banks are going to do, and the lenders are going to do what they have always done. They're going to get rid of them by deeply discounting the prices to try and attract people to come in the market to buy those houses. And Mr. President, what that does to Mr. and Mrs. America who lives in a house and is making their payments is it depresses the value of their house. It lowers their home equity line of credit availability because values go down. And it stagnates the very consumer this economy has depended on over the last decade for the longest protracted period of growth in our history. So, Mr. President, I come to Florida today to ask all the members of the Senate to take a look at 2766, to take a hard look at it, to make sure they look back at the history of 1975 when we faced almost an identical problem, took the strategic action that this bill recommends, and had a result that was absolutely right for the economy, right for the American homeowner. I understand all kind of incentives. I understand giving money back. I understand trying to incent people to do things, but nothing better than helping to make them the number one investment that every American family wants to make. An incentive to do that at a time that very market is in trouble is one of the keys to seeing to it that whatever lies ahead for us in our economy is a much lower trough and maybe even a peak where we at the right time strategically invest in the American family and home ownership and take those houses in ownership by lenders and put them in the ownership of families. Mr. President, I yield back the balance of my time and would suggest the absence of a quorum.
The clerk will call the roll.
Mr. Akaka.